general, the nose should be inside. Again, there's the width of the nose, there's a projection of the nose, is V, and this is one of the assessments where this is 0.67 projection to 1. I think it looks better, and I'm writing a paper about that. If that's 1.618, which is 5, and this is 1, okay? So that actually, it comes out to about 1.49, all right? But the 1.68 fits better. And again, those are like standard textbook descriptions, but that doesn't mean they're right. It's just somebody wrote a paper, and now everybody copies that for the last 20 years. So what is the problem in the nose? Bump, wide tip, droops when they smile, I won't take photos, my self-esteem is low. But the first three are number 1, 2, and 3 complaints in the last 2,000 people we went back and did a retrospective analysis and called them and said, listen, what were your main complaints, the chart reviews of my own patients? Okay, this, just look at the eyebrows and you know this was done in Iran, okay? This is, and so I didn't do this nose, I'm just using this as an example. They're happy with this nose, okay? If I did this nose in New York City, they'd run me out of town, okay? So they just don't like this nose. But in Iran, if you don't do this, you didn't do enough, and why do they go to you? Okay? Notice it's deprojected and such. So this is what my patients come in and ask. I don't know if you can guys read this. A patient has written this down. I want a symmetrical, narrower bridge, refined tip, feminine, natural enhancement, keep size, but I don't want a pinched nose, I don't want turned up piggy nostrils, I don't want it too strong or too masculine, okay? Same thing, this is, you, routinely people come in and bring me pictures of this. The morning of surgery, they're like, by the way, this is the nose that I like. Okay, another one, make tip less droopy, make nose overall smaller, no ski slope or piggy nose. And she's, some of these are the ones I've done, and a couple, that one is the one that she wants to look like from the front. So I take every nose differently. Now these are all noses that I've done. She's Albanian, okay? On the right, it's not a small nose, it's a smaller nose, okay? That's as much as I'm gonna turn that nose up. I'm not gonna make it any smaller. And she's very happy with it, and I can't tell you how many people we get for that. But that's the U.S. Northeast where I am. It may be different where you are, but you have to tailor it. And that's the front view, okay? So you see it softens her face, it doesn't draw attention. The picture on the left draws attention. And if you look, it's the same person, but you can probably see her eyes or notice her eyes a little bit more. This is an Armenian patient. She actually works for us, okay? So again, you wanna take attention away. Here's a 15-year-old patient. You can wait on these, but when the parents bring you in and say she won't even go out of the house and stuff, so you do it, you straighten it, you don't turn it up on a young girl like this. The man didn't want the big bump, and it was really crooked from the front. This is a pair of sisters, okay? Again, if you measure this now, if you measure from the tip up, from here to here, this is one, that's closer to the golden ratio, and that's why it looks better. This is her sister who came in and did her nose once her sister did her nose. This is a Moroccan patient, okay? That's it on the table, and that's her probably about a year later, okay? So if you took that picture in Iran, they'd probably say it's not small enough, but when you compare it, it's just right. No one knows she's had it done, and everybody thinks she looks better. Here's a girl from Nicaragua. I mean, again, that just draws your attention at whatever angle you look at it, okay? So you just make it smaller, but if you just look at some patients, if you just look at the after picture, can you tell anything was done? That's the goal. Indian patient, sorry, Pakistani patient. In real life, that nose was really, really big, okay? So she's categorically beautiful, but the nose had to be just smoothed out a little bit. Peruvian, a little bit of a curve, a little bit of a wider nose. She still retains her ethnicity, and identity, but just the nose is out of, well, it was a little bit more masculine on the left, on the before, and a little bit more feminine on that. This is a girl only a week after surgery. When they tell you that when I'm at the restaurant, I have to hold the menu up when the waiter comes up to order, you know that they should do something, whether with you or somebody else, just go do it, you know, get it done. Polish, crooked. See, if you just straighten the nose, it looks better. If it's crooked, it draws attention. Okay? It just draws your eye to different parts of her face. UAE from Abu Dhabi. Okay, again, just very masculine, very big, draws attention, you really doesn't let you focus on the rest of her face. This is a patient of ours. She's pretty popular. She had 300,000 followers on Instagram 3 years ago when we did her nose. Now she's got 19 million. So she went from being funny on Instagram to being funny and really beautiful, and everybody like talks about her looks now. So let's talk a little bit about non-surgical rhinoplasty, because that's important, and that's something probably, who does non-surgical rhinoplasty in this audience? Okay, who wants to do non-surgical rhinoplasty? Okay, does anybody come asking for that? Your patients asking for non-surgical rhinoplasty? So that's when somebody doesn't want to do surgery, maybe they're a little afraid of surgery, or wants to trial and run, or if they've had surgery, they don't want to do anything else, they want to just smooth it out a little bit. For me, 100% of patients that we've treated either repeat it, or move on to surgery, or they moved away somewhere else, so they like it. But it's a very dangerous thing to do if you don't know what you're doing and it has the complications, but we'll talk about that. So I use a 1cc syringe. I want to go through this technique. I really elevate the skin and soft tissues. I inject very small amounts, retrograde. They tell you to stay in the midline, but I'll show you why. That might not even be safe. You limit your injections, and remember the collateral circulation that I showed you on that other slide. Because this talk was about the mid-face, I quickly threw in this about buccal fat pad. How many people do buccal fat pad here? That's when you want to slim this part of the face. Okay, so you take it out, and it slims, you know, when you want higher cheeks and you want it to come in a little bit before you hit the jawline. And this is the buccal fat pad. It's a procedure you can do under local anesthesia. Okay, so back to the nose. Remember when we said stay in the midline? Look what's in the midline, okay, when you're injecting. So it's, and that's right on periosteum, okay? So it doesn't matter if you think you're in